Remember those neat Easter eggs which we got from Google, like do a recursion? I think it was like regular recursion itself, where just Google says you did you mean recursion all over again. There's a very neat thing which I rediscovered again on Google that was do a barrel roll, right? And you can see that it sort of like just spins the whole page around. So I just wanted to do a quick video on how exactly that works using a very cool feature of DevTools as well. So let's just zoom in a little and that should be good. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do in order to, you know, just investigate if this is some JavaScript or CSS animation is I'm gonna obviously go to the resources tab, refresh this, and I'm gonna try to pause the script execution. And let me tell you, what do I mean by that? So let's just go ahead and refresh this one more time and pause the script execution. You can see that it still is playing that animation, right? Now, when you pause the script animation, the script execution, the JavaScript world freezes. The V8 stops executing JavaScript like 100% on that page. But if you see that the animation still goes on and on and on, let's try this one more time, refresh, pause. You can see the animation is still happening. This clearly means that this animation is happening on the CSS thread. And how can I say that? That is because CSS runs on a different thread, right? So when your browser runs the, you know, the JavaScript and the CSS, they're running on two separate threads. That is why your CSS is not like very comfortable in talking with JavaScript, right? That is why these are like two different isolated sort of things. Although you have APIs to bridge some gaps, but not really like, you know, CSS directly communicating with JavaScript. So anyway, that's one thing. The other thing is that now how do we figure out what animation is running? So if you go to here in the three dots and you go to more tools and click on this animations, you get this cool little panel in animations and it says listening for animations. So let's just go ahead and refresh this and you can see that we get a single animation on the upfront, right? So this is a single animation which got played. So let's just click on this and now you can see that, hey, I can just pick this bad boy here and just drag it down, seeing how the animation gets carried out, right? So let's see at the top. So you can see it's a typical 360 degree roll and you can see it's a 4 second animation and this happens on the body of the page because of this particular class, right? Or maybe like not really class, just the body. You see we have an animation named roll, 4 seconds and just once, right? So if you go ahead in the search page and you can see that let's see, nope, this is something else, or maybe like that was it. So if you go to this, format this nicely and take a look, you can see that we have a keyframes roll, which at 100%, that means at zero it's nothing, but at 100% it's transform rotate 360 degree. That is why you get that effect, right? And you can see that this in fact is an Easter egg. Google injects it like this. I'm not sure how they do it. Maybe they probably have a good framework of, you know, of Easter eggs alone, given that how large Google is. So even if I have a, you know, a typo or something, I think this should work, or maybe not. So if I have a do a barrel roll like this, nope. So maybe they are using exact keyword match. I don't know. Does this work 10 times? Nope, this does not also work. So maybe like, you know, they are just doing an exact keyword match. I don't know what their backend is, but on the front end, it's a very simple animation. Yeah, it probably looks like an exact keyword match. But anyway, that's all about how the barrel roll works on Google. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this simple small video. If you liked it, if you learned something new, basically this animations panel, which is pretty cool for debugging your animations. So if you learned something new, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel. That really helps. That's all for this one. I'm gonna see you in the next video really soon.